are watching Cinema Resonates Live, and here we are discussing frame rates. Even after decades of discussion, still frame rates pose a threat to the filmmakers. Frame rates are a part of production and post-production workflow in cinema and video production for other mediums. But here I will discuss solely filmmaking. In this field, we come across two common frame rates, 24fps and 23.976fps. So at the end of the video, I will tell you which frame rate to choose when for your production and post-production workflow. I presume by now you know that 24fps frame rate is the engine behind the sweet cinematic lie, a lie that we all love.
God, I love it.
If it's so, then why bother about 23.976? And how did this figure come out, and why is it necessary to talk about this? Are you ready? Okay, let's dive in. In earlier filmmaking, mostly 35mm film strips were used, and they are quite good for shooting 24fps films, and they used to get edited in linear editing systems and projected in 24fps across cinema halls. Everything was fine and dandy until analog came into the picture. When analog technology developed and TV became a household term, then it liberalized the multimedia. If you are here, I'm sure you might have stumbled upon terms like NTSC and PAL. I'll not take much time, but trust me, it's necessary to talk about them before we talk about the decimal frame rate instead of integer frame rate. In the USA, electric supply is of 60Hz, and in Europe and Asian countries, it's 50Hz. So to deliver media over the air through analog signals, both USA and Europe came up with their independent system called NTSC and PAL respectively. Due to the 60Hz frequency of AC power in the USA, they chose to deliver their footage at 60i or 60 fields per second to reduce the intermodulation. The I here stands for interlaced. But again, what is interlacing? To transfer video signal, two processes were invented, that is progressive and interlaced. We may talk about it in a later video. For now, just keep in mind that interlaced was selected as an easy method to conserve bandwidth. This way, 30fps video became the standard to deliver through NTSC. Why 30fps? Well, this is because in interlaced scanning, each image is divided into two fields, upper and lower, thus creating 60 fields which are projected alternatively to go smoothly with 60Hz AC. Everything was going fine, then the color got introduced into the television. But old black and white VHF TVs were unable to process the signal, so signal divided into chrominance and luminance, and an extra color signal was sent with the luminance signal. So the problem was solved then. No, it couldn't. The color signal frequency sent along with the luminance could interfere with the audio frequency, thus causing intermodular beating. Then the engineers came up with a solution, which was to decrease the frame rate by 0.1%. Therefore, the frame rate came down to 29.976fps, and the field rate came down to 59.94 fields per second from 60 fields per second. In the same way, 0.1% frame rate reduction was applied to 24fps as well, and the frame rate came down from 24 frames per 1 second to 24 frames per 1.001 second, that is 23.976fps. Well, at this point, I would like to mention an important thing which people still get confused with, that is 0.976 in 23.976fps is not a fraction of a frame, but it's 24 frames every 1.001 seconds. But the problem just wouldn't go. This is because to run a 23.976fps video in a 29.976Hz video field, we have to have 5 frames, but we have just 4. Now they had to take the second step to spread these 4 frames in 5 fields. To accomplish this, they came out with a process called 2-3 pulldown, sometimes also called as 3-2 pulldown. For this process, let's say we have 4 frames, that is A, B, C, and D. The first frame fills up the upper and lower field. The second frame fills up the upper, lower, and the upper field. The next frame fills up the lower and the upper field. And the last frame fills up the lower, upper, and lower field. So, 2-3, 2-3. Now you might be thinking that this would affect the 24fps. Well, not so much. Although 4 frames were distributed among 5 fields, the average video fill covered by one video frame is 2.5. So if we divide the total number of fills, then it gives us 24. All these things are of the past, and the technology turned 180 degrees with the introduction of digital TV. Now they can display true 24, 30 and 60 FPS. NTSC in the USA has been replaced by ASTC. Japan, which had been using NTSC, has developed its own digital system, DVB-T, which is also used by other Asian countries, including India. DVB-T, which uses MPEG-2 and MPEG-4 codec for digital transmission over SDTV and HDTV, still uses the progressive and interlaced method. I have talked a lot about the engineering developments and the choices that had been taken to accomplish what we today receive through cinema, TV, YouTube, and other digital platforms. Now let's talk about the choices that a director, cinematographer, or an editor should take to deliver the desired film that they want to make. The production phase. Unless you are filming on a film camera, there is almost no reason you would have 24 FPS. But these days, some high-end digital cameras can shoot in real 24 FPS. But sometimes you might get tricked by the camera companies. They refer 23.976, 29.976 as 24 and 30 FPS respectively. Although these videos were shot in 24 FPS in a Nikon DSLR camera, they were actually shot in 23.976, aka 23.98. If you go into the Premiere Pro, you can use any non-linear editing system, and you want to start a project, the first thing that you need to do is to create a sequence. To create a sequence, click on this new item icon here and go to the sequence, and it opens up the sequence settings. There are some presets given here, but let's go into the settings section. If the video is shot in DSLR, then you can select that. But for the time being, let's select custom and come down to the time base. This is why we select the frame rate of the project. There are a lot of FPS settings all the way from 10 FPS to 60 FPS. But if we are going with 24 FPS, then it's for the obvious reason that you want to deliver it through DCP to project at digital theaters in 24 FPS as well. There are other things to be set as well, such as frame rate, pixel aspect ratio, fields, and display format. I'll talk about all of this in a later video. So to get the notification, subscribe and press the bell icon. Share if you can, because
caring is sharing.
Sharing.
Okay.
Sharing.
With Ola.
You know the deal. Although without using custom setting, you can choose a hassle-free way of setting up a project using a shortcut. What you need to do is to bring the clip in the project bin. Then you can hold and drag the clip into the new item icon, and it will create a sequence based on how the clip was shot. You can also right-click on the clip and click new sequence from the clip. You can make fine changes if you want by going into the sequence settings. But what if your show is targeted for both over-the-air TV and DCP? If your show is targeted for both over-the-air TV and DCP, I would recommend you shoot and edit in 23.976 FPS. Since over-the-air stations always demand a specific exact duration, while film theaters don't. So you can make your master at 23.976, edit it for the television station's exact duration. Then you can make a version for DCP at exact 24. Even the duration will be slightly different for DCP. It won't matter because the film theaters don't ask for a precise duration the way over-the-air television stations do. Therefore, next time you go for watching a film, just keep in mind that the medium, which works like a charm, needs its basic building blocks to remain firm. It's not just some old bloke deciding to stick to the old frame rates. They are sticking onto it because it works. A great deal of effort has been put on it by engineering minds, and since it has been arduously carried on by filmmakers to linger your experience to a great extent of time, to help you contemplate, which makes you a more sensible living being and you resonate more with life itself. Bye for now.